Today we'll be talking about what design tokens are and why you do not need to use them, so let's dive in. Hey, I'm Josh. I'm a developer advocate here at Zeppelin, and as I mentioned, we'll be talking about design tokens today with a focus on how developers can get the most out of them. But I'll start with why you do not want to use them, and you don't want to use them if you don't ever update your product's design. So if it's perfect the first time and nothing will ever change, then forget about the need for design tokens. You also don't need design tokens if you're just building for one platform. And you also don't need design tokens if you just love repetitive work and want to make things generally more difficult for yourself and your team. If you're that person and really won't ever use design tokens, then here's the part where you leave this video. Okay, we can get real now, I guess. So I've got a couple other videos coming up in this series with some practical examples of what's possible with design tokens in Zeppelin. But first, I thought we'd kick things off with a chat about what design tokens are and why you actually do need them. Now, when you're working with your product team, you want to get away from using language like, oh, this top padding of this button is 12 pixels. The color is hex 123456, you know. Instead, we'll say things like the padding is spacing medium. Or the color is
Tark liver?
Wait, what is Tark liver? Oh my. So a few reasons to move away from that kind of language is that it's cumbersome. And those specific values that you're using might change. And whether it's a website or a mobile app, whatever you're working on really, tokens allow designers and developers to work together to create a consistent visual language that can be used across all the parts of the product. And you'll be able to quickly see how to save time and ensure that your project stays cohesive when you have all of your design elements, such as your colors, your typography, your spacing, you know, when you have them all tokenized. That's the one. I'll give a real quick practical example. So maybe your app needs to be co-branded with a partner's color scheme, or you want to be festive for the holidays and change up your theming. With our project set up using our design tokens, we can easily drop in our new colors in a single file in our code, instead of, you know, like every instance where that color is declared throughout the code base. Okay, so I'm not a designer, so don't trust me to choose those colors. Now, let's just take a look at how you can grab those design tokens from Zeppelin to use into your development projects. Once your design tokens are set up in Zeppelin by your designer, you'll be able to access them in your screens where you have that token declared. So for example, if one of our tokens for spacing is called spacing XS for what we'll call extra small, whenever that token is detected here, Zeppelin will show you that value as the token you've named when you inspect it. So that's helpful for me as a developer to not have to always be thinking in actual numbered pixel values and just use the token names right there. And next, there's a couple of different ways to get all of your design tokens from Zeppelin into your code base so that you can start using it as you build out your app. And that will be available here in your style guide when you click on the export design tokens icon on the lower left there. And Zeppelin offers a URL here to fetch that JSON representation of the design tokens. And if you want to write a script to manipulate any of this data so it makes most sense for you, then you can do that through Zeppelin's public API. And I've got a video I'll link in the description below on how to get started with that, and also link you to the public API docs. But if I also click on fetch here, you can see what that JSON looks like and copy and paste it if you want. And if you're going to just be doing this one time, then fetching is probably fine. But if you're setting up something more complex in your pipeline, then the API would definitely be the way to go. Another alternative that Zeppelin provides for you is that you can download all of your design tokens here as separate JSON files. And here we'll see that we see the same standard design token format available for you to manipulate to your heart's content. All right, that'll do it for today's quick intro to design tokens for developers in Zeppelin. Come join us on Zeppelin's Discord community. I've linked it below in the description, and you can ask the community questions or let us know how you're working with design tokens and how it's benefited your developer handoff. I'll be back soon with some more practical examples of how to really get the most out of your design tokens and automate your workflow. I'll see you next time.